Roar! Or whatever.
Hey Dino fans, Debosaurus here, and I'm very excited today because finally, here it is, the Wave 2 Jurassic World Roarivore Ceratosaurus. Straight from Isla Sorna. If we take a look at the package here, we can see the Jurassic World logo, as well as the familiar artwork with Owen and Blue, the name Ceratosaurus Roarivore, ages 3+. It has an action picture in the lower right-hand corner, and in the upper right-hand corner, we can see it has the roaring icon, as well as the blue label that says new, indicating that it is, in fact, Wave 2. If we look at the back here, we see that it has the Jurassic World logo and says Ceratosaurus in 4 different languages. It has the Try Me button and the sound icon, as well as an action picture. And it does have the blue footprint, indicating that it will have a QR code on its foot for the Jurassic Facts app. And you will be able to find the QR code pictures on my Facebook page, which should be linked in the description. But just in case it's not, it is Debosaurus Rex on Facebook. If we look in the lower left-hand corner, we see the familiar yet different collection picture. We can see that the other roarivores in this collection are the Pteranodon FMM27, Ankylosaur FMM25, a Triceratops, which looks very similar to that one, FMM24. I'd be interested to know if that's actually different. I haven't seen it in the store yet. The Ceratosaurus is FMM29, and the assortment for these roarivores is FMM23. I'm really excited to have a new Ceratosaurus toy. Let's get it out of the package and take a closer look. Getting this dino out of its package isn't too hard. You simply snip the plastic. There's a clear plastic one and then 2 sets of plastic strings. The difficult part is that the tail is inserted through this blister pack, so you have to either open the whole box and trim it with your knife if you want to save it, or if you're throwing the package away like me, I just tore it off and took the tail out. I thought I was going to have to open the bottom of the box to get the instructions, but sneaky, sneaky, they've stuffed them in the side of the box, so I don't have to tear apart the bottom of this box to get the instructions. Very cool. I hope that no one loses their instructions. The instructions are pretty basic. Because his tail came separate from his body, we're going to have to attach the tail, and we'll look at that in a minute. But something I have not mentioned before with the roarivores, and it's quite important, is that there is a battery compartment that you can open and replace the batteries. So if your dinosaur's not roaring properly, after you've played with it for a while, have your parent check the batteries and make sure the batteries are not dead. There aren't really any registration pins or anything on the tail, but they painted the color all the way down the tail so we can line it up with the body and know exactly which way it's supposed to go. All you have to do is put the peg into this slot on the back. I know, I'll be gentle. And push. Once you hear the click, the tail is on, and you're ready to play. As far as posability, tail will rotate once it's attached, so, you know, if you get it on wrong or slightly off-kilter, you can adjust it. But it lines up so good with the colors. I love it. They finally put color on the tail. Awesome! And the stripes on the leg line up with the body, but the legs do move. He's got all kinds of color. He's got like a gold and a yellowy and then like a lime green color and this beautiful bright red color and these tiger stripes. Just beautiful, beautiful animal. I love it. The arms will rotate out and up and down, like all the way around. So you can kind of get crazy with the arms, both sides. And he does stand on his own. I just love this coloring. I absolutely love it. If we check out the roar feature, it has a button on its back. I think that's 5 different sounds. Hopefully you could hear them. I don't like playing sounds from sound toys because usually they sound like garbage on recordings, but it is what it is. Let's take a closer look at the sculpt on the head because it is spectacular. All of the ridges and the nostrils and the individual pointy teeth, the painted eyes. You can see here. You can see here both sides of my dino have the eyes applied correctly. Hopefully that's a sign that they're paying attention. We have a lovely horn on its nose and the ridges above the eye here. Again, the lovely pointy teeth. The inside of the mouth is sculpted and painted. Individual teeth, like I said. And a lovely light pink tongue, and they've made the fleshy bits in its jaw also a lighter pink. Way up in there you can see part of the assembly, but you don't normally see that during normal play. Obviously here on the bottom we have the speaker, and we have the battery compartment for changing batteries. But it is still sculpted. The only thing that's different about these is I don't remember seeing this on previous dinos. I guess because this is a smaller scale than the Rex. Maybe they had to make the mechanism a little different. But it doesn't really take away from the toy, because when you're looking at it like this, you can't see it at all. It is still sculpted on the bottom, and the paint stripes go all the way down the tail, down the side. Lovely pebbled texture on its back. You can see its ribs and the folds of skin. Little beefy arms. I really like the Ceratosaurus, so it's nice to have a good Ceratosaurus toy. So we can see it has the QR code on the foot, and on the other foot it has the Jurassic logo. You can also see here an example of the inclusions in the plastic that kind of look like volcanic ash. It's on all the dinos. And again, I'll be posting the QR codes on my Facebook page. Here's what the Ceratosaurus looks like next to the Thrash and Throw T-Rex. And also, here's how it compares to the Roarvor's Triceratops from Wave 1. You can see it's a smaller carnivore, but no less fearsome or awesome. Something I did just notice about the legs is that they will pivot outward to widen the stance. If you change the way it's standing, you may have to widen the stance to get it to stand up, but it will stand on its own. Come on, Ceratosaurus. Don't make a liar out of me. She's done it. Ceratosaurus will stand on its own. I did have to finagle with it some, but there you go. And not going anywhere, not going to fall over and ruin my entire display. Thank you, Mattel. 2 thumbs up. Excellent job. I hope that you've enjoyed this look at the Mattel... I hope that you've enjoyed this up-close look at the Mattel Jurassic World Ceratosaurus Roarvoar from Wave 2. If you have, please press the like button, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more content. And until next time, happy hunting!